So hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and I don't know what number Artcast this is. It's been a long time since I've done one, so it's anybody's guess, right? I'm just sitting here painting another Red Sonja piece, and just thought I'd do a little shooting. I actually had kind of an idea tonight. A while back, I bought this, what is it? It's like a power, it's basically a thing where you can plug your camera into the wall. Oh, it's a decoy battery, or I can't remember what they actually call it. I think it's not a decoy battery, but it's, well, maybe it is. It's like a fake battery, basically, with a cord coming out of it. And you put it in your camera, and then your camera can just keep on going. You know, it doesn't need the batteries to replace because it's just drawing power out of the wall. But anyway, I was sitting in here painting and thinking about recording a show, but I really like to record with this camera here, the one that I've got set up, which is my nicer camera. And I used to always record these shows with my webcam, and the webcam's nice because it just runs and runs, you know, never quits. But this one likes to shut off after about 10 minutes. And if I'm not careful, it'll shut off on me, and I'll just be sitting here talking or thinking it's going, and it won't be. But anyway, I had this thought. I thought, well, what if I plugged that power source into my camera? I wonder if it would still turn off automatically after 10 minutes. Because, you know, when you think about it, like, I mean, I use this thing for animation. The camera sits out there and never turns off while I animate. It just keeps going. And, you know, they also, you know, people also use these things for, like, time-lapsed, you know, star pictures, like where they point the camera up in the sky and just take a real, like, long time-lapse shot of the stars going around the sky and stuff. And, you know, it's like, this kind of makes sense that if you're doing that, the camera's staying on. So of course, I wonder if, like, when they do that, it's probably like clicking a picture every now and then, but still the camera's got to come on. It wouldn't shut itself off and bring itself back on. Anyway, I thought I'd just, you know, experiment a little, do a little Artcast, give that a try, and just see how it works. I wanted to tell everybody too, I watched a video like yesterday, and I wanted to make a video about this myself, so I'll just use this opportunity to tell you guys. But I caught this thing about something that eBay did lately, and I know that some of you guys that watch me sell on eBay like I do, and I guess there's like a glitch or something in the settings on eBay, something they changed recently. Basically what it does is it doesn't let your customers pay with PayPal. It says that, you know, that you don't want them to pay with PayPal, which is like, if you're selling on eBay and you're not accepting PayPal, you're not going to do very well, since that's pretty much what most people use on there. And I saw this video and I went and checked my own settings, and sure enough, they were changed, so that I couldn't accept PayPal. And what's kind of funny is I listed two pieces for sale this week, and both of them didn't sell, which is just odd, you know. Like, I mean, sometimes I'll have pieces that don't sell, but, you know, for two in 1 week to not sell, it just makes me think that something was up. And how do you switch this back? I mean, you go into, I mean, actually, I'll link the video. I'll find the video and link it. on the screen, so that if any of you guys are having this problem, maybe you could go in there and check it and make sure it's set to the right thing, you know. But yeah, that's a little spooky, you know. Just I don't know why in the world they would change that without telling anybody, but I just wonder what's happening to, you know, just everybody's sales right now, and if it did actually happen to other people, because that could just be like massively detrimental, especially if you're making your living off of just eBay, you know. It's a simple thing to fix, but now that I've switched it, I'm just kind of curious if, because I relisted both those pieces, and I'm just kind of curious to see, like, if it'll sell now. So, one's an Indiana Jones piece I kind of held on to for a while. I think I got them up here. Let me see. Yeah, actually, I do. They're both sitting here. I'll bring them down, try not to touch my piece. There's a sketch, actually, for, comic cover I need to do. Some of you guys might remember I did this other comic cover with this Reaper character, and so this is like the second one in the series. Here's the one. It's like this nude. I thought was a pretty nice piece. I was really surprised it didn't even get one bid. And then this other one. It's just this Indiana Jones drawing I did a while back. I really like this one. If it doesn't sell, I might just keep it and hang it up, because it's just a nice piece, I think. Other things we've been doing that's been going on this week is we had like this big leak from one of the fish tanks. Tanya bought a new filter, and there was something the matter with it, and it leaked a bunch of water all over our living room floor. And we had, like, you know, our carpet in the living room was not very good. You guys probably have noticed if you watch any of my other videos where I walk around the house and filming. But it was just never very good in this apartment. It's kind of trashed anyway. But I had already cut out like this other spot where we had another water problem once before. When we had that big old flood here in Boulder. So when I cut this part out, there was hardly any carpet left. So anyway, we decided to go get some carpet and put it in the living room and also down the hallway. And so we spent a couple days. I think it took like 3 days total. Now we're kind of like putting the house back together. But that was fun. An experience. I've actually never laid carpet before now, which is weird because I've done, you know, all kinds of other construction, but just never did carpet for whatever reason. So I had to kind of look up how to do it a little bit on the internet and read up on it a little bit, but it wasn't hard. I mean, you know, my living room's not too big. I'm sure if you had a bigger area, it might be a little bit more complicated, but it wasn't too hard. It wasn't too bad. And it looks really nice now. And Tanya's happy. And it's actually nice, you know, to fix the house up a little bit. Because I don't know, you know, I guess I'm like the, you know, what do they call that? Like the guy who, you know, sells shoes and his kids are barefoot kind of thing. I mean, I was in construction, but, you know, my house was like horrible. I never really worked on my own house much. And, I don't know. You know, when you do that work for a living, you don't feel like doing it when you get home, you know? That's not really not much of an excuse. And I think, too, like, me and Tanya never really intended to stay in this house that long. I think we just kind of looked at it like, we're just going to stay here for a while, and we'll be out of here. Now we've been here, like, 10 years, and it's just like, we really should fix this place up, and, get it looking better. But anyway, the carpet's kind of like a first step, I guess. And they had this cheap, really cheap cherry flooring up there on sale. And I'm going to go back. I'm going to see if it's still there. I imagine it probably will be. They had lots of boxes of it. And I think I'm going to lay that in the kitchen. Like, our kitchen's pretty small, too. It's only like 100 and something square feet. And so it won't take much of that stuff. So I always kind of intended to tile the kitchen, but I just think, you know, that might be a little nicer. It's hard to tile things on this damn trailer for some reason. It's weird. It, like, moves so much, you know? I tiled the bathroom, and it was just hard to keep the tiles down on the floor. A couple of them, like, immediately popped up after I did it, and then, you know, kind of just, you know, they're just, like, prone to crack and pop, you know, and I think it's just because, you know, like, the floor, you know, it just, I don't know, maybe just because the thing doesn't set on a foundation, just makes it a little bit more wobbly, I guess, I don't know, sounds terrible, like, my house isn't wobbling, but. You know, it's just all that. So I've been kind of, anyway, like, the point was, is I've been thinking about, you know, what else to put in the kitchen as flooring, and I don't really like linoleum. I mean, that's, like, cheap as hell, but this stuff, is like, on sale is just about as cheap as, well, probably not, but it's not very expensive, though. It was like 70 cents a square foot or something. So just really affordable. And it looks really good too. It's like that pre-finished flooring. So I wouldn't have to, like, sand it and varnish it or anything like that. So anyway, I might be doing that later this week or in the day. My schedule's kind of switched to being nights for art. Which is, I guess, good, because that's when I always did it when I was working. I used to, you know, stay up, like, super late and paint, and then, you know, get up the next day and drag my ass to work, all dead tired, do that whole thing. So I'm sure there's a lot of other people still doing that. So I know where you're at, man. It sucks. I remember my old boss, Joe, used to always be asking me, like, how come I was, like, so tired at work? I never used to really tell him or, like, hardly anybody that I was an artist, so it was just always, like, a mystery. I don't know if they just thought I was an insomniac or what, but, I mean, that's what it was. I was trying to run, like, two businesses, basically. I was doing my own at night, and then I'd have to get up during the day and go and do my painting job. I guess that's what it takes. So I did that for years. I think anybody who does art long enough, you know. I mean, yeah, every now and then you hear of somebody who's just like, I've never had another job or whatever. But in my experience and the people I've known, God, it's just, you know, it's hard not to have another job. I did another Red Sonja painting earlier, not this week, but maybe last week, I guess. Might have been two pieces ago now. So I already sold it and sent it and everything, but it came out really nice, and I just was like, after I painted that, I was like, I want to paint another one. Maybe not Red Sonja, but just kind of like fantasy-esque type thing, you know? And, I was just looking through my sketchbook, and I had a sketch for this one, and I thought, oh, I'm going to do that, you know. It might come out pretty cool, and I'm thinking it might. I want to go, like, of course I've laid in the black now. Let me show you guys the full piece. Kind of zooming back a little. But, laid in, like, all the blacks, and then, of course, the moon's behind her, and I did a little texture on the moon. So, like, once I put some black in there and wipe it out. I think that's going to be pretty cool. And then, of course, she's going to have, like, red hair and a red cloak and, like, silver. Thinking, like, you know, the classic silver chainmail bikini thing. And then, I don't know about the gauntlets. I was almost thinking make those, like, gold. But I just think, like, the real red on the black is going to be very striking. And there's a lot of black in this. You know, the black goes around. It's in her cape, you know, everything. So, anyway, that's what I'm going to be going for with this one. What else? I don't know. How did I used to do, like, hour-long shows of just me talking? I'm not sure. I think it's been over 10 minutes, though, because it's 12:08, and I think I started at 11:50 or something like that. So this thing keeps... Okay, so I'm back. Now I'm just going to just check. I'm not quite sure where it jumped off of. But, it actually quit because the card ran out of space. So, what is it? 12:10 right now. And now I'm going to just see how long this thing will run. I just stuck an 8 gig card in there. And we'll just see how long I can get out of an 8 gigger. Because what's kind of cool is the battery thing's just working, you know, gangbusters. It's working totally fine, which I thought it would. But now I just want to see like what kind of time I can get. Because it'd just be nice if, you know, I could set a timer or something, know when the thing's going to turn off. When it turned off from the card, you know, I just didn't hear it. I wish there was a beep for that. I really wish there was a beep. Because it wouldn't be quite so bad if there was a beep. Because the bad part is you continue to talk. And just like now, I don't know where it quit at. You know, I don't know where the end was on this thing. So, we'll see how this one works anyway. So anyway, let's see. What should I talk about? So I guess let's talk about laying in blacks. It's kind of like inking, really. And technique, you know, this is definitely... Well, I don't know. I was going to say this is definitely a technique I learned from Struzan, but I remember reading about Boris basically doing kind of the same thing. Laying in blacks before he... Or was it Boris? Oh, I can't remember now. Might be wrong. I know Boris would do like a tonal painting, like an underpainting in sepia tone. Like before he would paint over it with oil. And then I think he would actually... I think it wasn't Boris, actually. So I wonder who else I'm thinking of now. I'm not sure. Maybe it was just Struzan. But anyway, with Boris's technique, I know that he, you know, he would do a tight drawing, sepia, you know, basically like a wash type ink job over top of it, and then he would paint over the top of that with acrylics, and just do like washes of color. So you kind of wash over like a skin tone over the people, or a blue over the sky, or whatever. And then he would do kind of like this washy kind of layer of oil paint, and mainly concentrate on the backgrounds, you know, just like knock in sort of like that sky and all that kind of stuff, and then paint the people very tightly on top, which is an interesting technique. It's a good one. I always, you know, that it always was a little weird to me, because I'm just, you know, I could never get my head around doing the background before, you know, the figures. And, you know, I've heard different, like, art teachers, you know, kind of thing. My mother-in-law took this art class, you know, oil painting class, and somebody told her that, you know, paint the figures or I mean paint the background first, because the figures lay over the background, so that just makes sense, you know. Which that, yeah, that makes sense, but it's totally not the way I do it, you know. I just can't imagine caring enough about the background to paint it all before I paint the figures. That's just, you know, crazy to me, really. I want to work on the most important thing right away, and I always feel like the first thing I do is like the best thing I do, and as I go and as I kind of lose my energy and get, you know, more tired, then that's when I'm painting more like, you know, the stuff that's less important, like the background, you know, things like that, things that can be looser. Because, you know, if you're just, you know, like painting, I don't know. I mean, some backgrounds are really involved, like a jungle or something, but if you're, you know, painting like clouds or sky or something, or just kind of misty something, it's like, it's all sort of like an accidental kind of wash anyway, so, you know, what's the difference, you know? But maybe that's also kind of the thought process between kind of like a Boris type techniques, is, you know, he can throw in the backgrounds with this kind of like big strokes, kind of, you know, very watercolor-esque kind of oil wash. And then it's just done and you don't have to mess with it anymore. So, everybody's got their own technique. There's a million different ways to skin a cat, right? And art is no different. I mean, in a lot of ways, art is a little bit, you know, it's like, I mean, it's no different in, you know, in the sense of anything you're trying to do, but it is actually different in, you know, like, as compared to, like, learning, oh, man, I'm getting all kind of in the weeds, but, like, if you're trying to, say, rebuild a carburetor or something, or learn how to build a barbecue or something, you know what I mean? It's like, there's no sort of points for, like, originality when you're doing that, you know? You're probably better off just to figure out how somebody else did it and then just kind of copy them and just do it the way they did it. But in art, that doesn't really fly, because if you just do that, if I look at Boris or somebody and just go like, okay, Boris is the way, you know, Boris has got it figured out, I'm good. And then I just do what he does, then, you know, inevitably you get called a copy of, like, Boris. Like, I get called a copy of, like, Drew Struzan sometimes, you know. Or Frazetta, if I'm, you know, painting that way. Or Sam Keith, if I happen to be painting that way. There's a lot of guys that I've studied and, you know, absorbed stuff from. And, you know, people, you know, other artists pick up on that, so... And they're right in a sense, but, you know, you're not stealing. You learn, and I don't know. That whole thing is goofy. You know, because everybody learns from somebody, and everybody, you know, there's nobody that's just fully formed and born on the planet, you know, a genius. So, you know, everybody copies to learn in the beginning, so that's just how it is. And people, I think they love to, like, use comparisons just to describe things, you know what I mean? So, it's always, like, the go-to, even if you're doing something, like, original. Let's see how long I've went for. So, 12:18. I think I'm like 8 minutes in. That's pretty good. This camera's doing real well. We'll see what happens when I'm 10 minutes in. I think that's the shutoff point. My other camera, my like smaller, where's it at? This one here, the Canon, this is the one I take around to when I blog and stuff. See, it's got a little tripod on it right now. It's just so I could set it up outside and stuff. And that one won't shut off, actually. That one will just run and run. But I gotta admit, like, once I saw how this one films, I just fell in love with this camera. You know, like, it gives such a beautiful picture of the art, and it's just a really close representation of, like, you know, what I see. So, I don't know, I just was like, every time I think to go, like, well, just record an Artcast, who cares, you know, it's like, just record one with your webcam or something, you know. It's like the quality kind of bugs me now, you know, I think because I have better quality other places, so. See, that looks pretty good going down there. That's all the black I'll put in. It's good, too, like, you know, when you do the, or when I, you know, this is just my technique, so whatever. If you don't like it, that's fine. But, you know, like, the one thing I do like about throwing the blacks in first like this is it puts black in your piece, but it doesn't put black in your color. You know what I mean? And this is just a personal thing. I'm not, like, condemning anybody. But I personally don't like to mix black into any colors because I always feel like that's what gives that grayish, muddy tone. And so I stay kind of away from blacks. And I think that's kind of like why, you know, I can get away with, like, the bright colors and stuff, because I just don't put black in. But then, you know, like, once you have these big black areas, it makes black available to you. But you don't have to have it mixed in with your paint, you know. So that's, like, the whole thing. For me, anyway. There might be a different reason somebody else does it. But when I throw all this black underneath her hair, it just makes it easier to paint. Because it's going to be like this real lush red kind of thing. And, you know, like, once you have the blacks down, then all you have is those kind of middle tones and the highlights to put in. And you can keep your colors, like, nice and clean and bright and separate instead of having to, you know, change things as you go or whatever. It's just one technique. Somebody left a comment on one of my fantasy pieces. I painted this one where, like, Conan is, like, fighting these wolves. It's a ways back. You guys can go find it if you want to. But I painted it in oil. And, you know, I painted on canvas with no underdrying. And, you know, it's just another technique, you know. I painted a long time, so I've experimented with a lot of techniques. And these are just two that I've kind of kept. And, you know, it's like I've tried, like, a lot of different things. I don't know. I think, like, when you, you know, when you paint or do anything, you know, it's like, you're going to, you know, when you're learning how to do it, you're going to experiment and, you know, find your own way. And those experiments are, like, oftentimes, like, you know, very different, you know. It's not like there's ever a clear-cut path to, like, how you will paint in the future, you know. And even when you kind of think you got it figured out, things come along later on that change your technique. You know what I mean? And it's still happening in my art, I notice. Very much so. But anyway, that's all, you know. That's it for the art talk tonight, I guess. You guys ever got questions? I don't know. I always say, like, yeah, put them out there and I'll answer them. I try to answer them, like, on that live show, you know, the Artcasters live show thing that we all do. But if I forget, just ask me again. you know, my email's on my site. You can go to my site, email me, and just say, like, hey, you know, like that, you know, for you to answer this on the show if you can. Because I don't mind that, and it's kind of nice, because then, like, when it comes around to my turn to, like, think up a topic for that stupid show, you know, then I have some stuff. Because that drives me bonkers, is trying to, like, think up, like, a topic for that show. Like, when me and Scott and Kevin decided to do it, you know, it was kind of like, we wanted to stay off of, like, just talking movies and stuff the whole night. So we thought, well, yeah, we'll make topics. But it's like, you know, it's just really freaking hard to, like, think up topics to talk about, for crying out loud, because there's just not that much to talk about with art, you know? And a lot of times I think we're just, like, so hamstringed by trying to stay on, like, these dumb topics that we just don't ever get to anything interesting, but I might just be looking at it in a weird way. But yeah, you know, if anybody's got any kind of questions or something, just email me so I have something to talk about there. Is it still running? Yep, it's still running. How long has it been? So it's 12:26 now. That's pretty good. That's like 16 minutes or something, I think. If I'm right, I'm going to go back and listen to this video and see, like, you know, what I said, you know, in the beginning. Just to see how long this thing's going to go. So this is going to be kind of cool, because it's got, like, one strand kind of sticking out here like this. And then when I paint it, I'm going to try to, you know, I'll probably have some red kind of sprayed out on the moon a little bit. I'm going to try to keep that kind of shimmery look, you know, around her head. Just kind of oversprayed look, I guess. See how that goes. This brush is killing me, though. If I get it real wet, like I just did right there, it's like it gives me a big old line that I can actually shrink down to hardly anything. But, like when I want these just tiny little detail lines, it's either drying out, like the ink or like the paint basically is just getting sucked off the brush. And so it's kind of giving me a big, like, bloop of a line, or it's just kind of, just dying before I get to the end of it, you know. This board is, like, pretty rough right now. This is actually a piece of that old MDF that I used to paint on, which is, like, I guess an eighth thick. I think that's what it was. And I can't get it anymore. So now I use, like, a quarter inch thick, which is pretty thick, you know. And I would rather use this stuff. I love this stuff. And there's something about the surface where it, I don't know how to describe it, but it's just a little bit rougher or more raggy than the other stuff. And, I don't know. I don't know why, because it's all the same stuff, you know? It's all MDF, but I found this board up there, actually. I have two pieces of this stuff. So I'm going to try to do two really nice paintings on it, because I just love it, and this is probably going to be the end of this board, and I'll have to go back to using the thicker stuff. Which is fine. I mean, you know, I painted like a ton of paintings on that stuff already, so I know it works, but it just doesn't, you know, it's just like that artist thing, you know, you get something you really, really like, and by golly, they stopped making it, you know? I remember when I found those blue pencils, like these ones. I don't know if you guys can see, I'm not messing with the focus on this, so it's probably hard to see, but it's like Colorace, Prismacolor blues, basically. And they used to not be Prismacolors. Prismacolors bought them at one time. I think they were something else, like Stanford or something. They're just like the best color pencils to draw on. Not necessarily to paint with, but like just to draw, you know, like if you're drawing in like a sketchbook or something. All right, so it just clicked off, and what was awesome is that it clicked off with like a loud click, and then my camera went off. So I'm gonna go back and listen and see where that sucker went off at, and hopefully it just, you know, shut the camera off like as soon as it the card got full. But it might have actually waited a while. But it's looking like I got 20 minutes out of that card, which is, you know, nice. And if I know that, then I can set a little timer so that I know when the thing's going to run out. And that will help if I do any more of these. It was fun. I hope that, you know, you guys pulled up a chair and did some drawing and some listening like you guys used to do when you watched me. What should I say? I don't know. Like, subscribe, I don't know. Check out Patreon if you want to support my art, and that's about it. So, thanks for watching, guys, and maybe I'll do this again soon. See you later.